Hi guys, Lauren from RC Benchmark here. Welcome back to part two of our database video series. Today I'm going to be going into more detail on our filters and showing you how to use them to find the most efficient motor-propeller combination for your propulsion system. So we start on the landing page of the database, then click over to test data. Last time we went through the example filter, but today I'm going to take you through the individual options instead. Starting off under general, we can decide if we want to filter for single motor or dual motor configurations, and we can also see if there's a specific test stand that we want to see. Moving on to components. For motors, you can narrow your results based on a few options: shaft diameter, magnetic poles, kV value, or weight. And whatever parameter you choose, you can look for results that are greater than, less than, equal to, or any of these other options. For propellers, you can filter by diameter, pitch, and weight. And finally, for ESCs, you can look at max current, BEC current, and weight. Next up is data, and this allows you to filter by performance data for individual powertrains, such as thrust, torque, RPM, voltage, current, power, and various types of efficiencies. Or if you want to look at multi-rotor propulsion systems, we also have several options for those. Now finally, moving on to aggregate data, we have a few options here. First off, you can look at the maximum value of any of these parameters, and you can also filter them further to be, again, greater than, less than, equal to a certain value. You can look at the value interpolated at another value. So this would give you, for example, the total thrust when total electrical power is equal to 3 watts. And finally, we can look at the interpolated value of one variable at the maximum value of another variable. This is great for finding the conditions at which your motor is most efficient. So for example, we could find the total thrust at our maximum value of motor and ESC efficiency. So let's use this database with an example. Let's say I have a quadcopter with a preset frame that weighs 750 grams and will normally operate at about 5 newtons or 0.5 kgf of thrust. I've started with a 2200 kV motor with a plastic 6-inch propeller, and I've uploaded my data into the database, and here's the landing page with all of the information about that test. So I can use this data to estimate my flight time using RC Benchmark's flight time calculator. Now this flight time calculator is available on our website, and I'll also link it in the description. It's quite simple to use. Now the first thing you're going to want to do is make a copy in your own files, so I'll do that here. We'll open up the new one, then go back to the database, copy your data, and paste it into your sheet, and then put the actual numbers into the table. So I'll just copy them, and then I paste these up here. I then enter some extra information about my drone. I know that I have a 500 gram battery with a capacity of 74 watt hours. I have 4 props, and the weight of my drone without the battery is 750 grams. Now that we've put all this information as well as our data in, we get a flight time estimate of about 13 minutes. 13 minutes is okay, but I think we can do better, so I'll use the filter tool to see what the most efficient propulsion system would be for my setup. So, I am looking for single motor configuration with a propeller that is 6 inches in diameter, and I want to know which system is the most efficient at my operating point of 0.5 kgf. So I'll exclude empty results, so results that don't have a value for what I'm looking for. And then I will apply filters, and let's see what comes up. So then I'll go down here and I will sort the results by maximum efficiency, because that's what I'm most interested in. And I can see that the most efficient result was performed with a 2150 kV motor and a 6-inch propeller with a 3-inch pitch. So I'll scroll down to the test data here, copy that, put it into my sheet again, steal this data,
Now none of my other parameters are changing. They'll be roughly the same. But now when I look, my flight time is about 16.5 minutes with the new propulsion system, so that's even better. So this tool really demonstrates that finding the most efficient combination of components is the key to maximizing your flight time, not just the most efficient motor and propeller separately, but which combination works the best together. That's all I'm going to cover today. In the next video, I will look at how to upload your own data to the database. Thanks for watching.